Good morning, Mom. Good morning, Robert. I hope you guys had a good weekend. I hope you're preparing for this snow we're supposed to have this week. I hope that you're able to just stay warm and stay inside and everyone stay healthy through this crazy weather we're supposed to have. I hope I get some good news this week at the, well, this week tonight at the board meeting, because I'm recording this on Monday. I hope I get some good news at the board meeting about being able to come back in person. You'll be the first to know if that's the case. So stay tuned, but let's get started with our Go Noodle Flow. Here we go.
Melting, melting, melting. We all have those moments when we freeze. We can't move. We can't think. But with practice, we can get good at melting that frozen feeling. Let's freeze up and then melt. Stand up in a spot with a little space around you. Cross your arms and hold your shoulders with your hands. Carefully tuck your chin down and in. Tighten as many muscles in your body as you can. Let your body be frozen like an ice statue. Feet tight, legs tense, belly tight, shoulders up. Now, even make a frozen face. Close your eyes, your mouth, your jaw, tight. Feeling frozen? Really still? Now, little by little, begin to melt. Let your chin stay low as your face softens and melts. Your jaw opens slightly. Your eyes blink open just a little. Your mouth and cheeks melt and feel soft. You're melting. Let your shoulders melt and go down. Hands let go. Arms glide down to your sides. Melting. Let your legs melt too. Soften and bend. Melt. Try to melt all the way to the floor. Down, down, down. Let yourself be a blob, a puddle on the floor. Ah, melted all the way to soft. Exhale, long. Once frozen and tight, and now melted, a little more at ease. Let's do it again. This time, choose your own frozen statue. Be creative. Freeze your arms. Freeze your legs. Freeze your face. Make a funny face if you'd like. Freeze there. Tighten. Freeze, freeze, freeze. You're frozen. Close your eyes or keep them open. Stay frozen for just one more moment. Ready to melt? One icy part of you at a time begins to melt. Face, eyes, jaw, head, chin goes down, shoulders drop, fingers soften and droop, hands too, arms float down. You are melting. Let your legs allow you to melt down to the floor. Melt, 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 droop, settle, and rest. Melted. Try to feel at ease here. Soft. Check in on your body. Is any area still frozen? Notice that tightness. Melt it if you wish. Rest here. Breathe. Eyes are open or closed. Next time you feel frozen, in your mind or in your body, try to melt it away.
Excellent, excellent, excellent. So you know the first part of this. Make sure that we can stretch our arms out in front of us. We can press our switch to be able to activate our music and draw our letter. So please make sure that Go Noodle Flow helped you be able to do that. And we're going to do our brainer size to make sure both parts of our brain are working together to make sure we're working the hardest we can. Let's get started with that brainer size. I think the first one is your arms. Let's take a look. Where did everything go? Uh-oh. Well, that's not good. There it is.
Brainer size with Mr. Catman. Forwards, backwards, onwards.
Meow.
Mr. Catman isn't here. I hope he didn't forget about our brain exercises. Wait, he's back. Make large forward arm circles like Mr. Catman. Next, make large backward arm circles. Meow, let's combine the two. Do a forward arm circle with one arm while your other arm circles backward. You got it? Do a forward arm circle with one arm as your other arm circles backward. Clawsome. Pause and switch directions. Make the arm that was going forward go backward. And make the arm that was going backward go forward. Unfortunately, one side is always harder than the other. But as you know, practice makes perfect for real.
Excellent, excellent, excellent. We like that brainer size. We hope that it's growing on you a little bit. We're gonna jump right in. Sorry about what the heck's that. We're gonna jump right in and get started with that work with letters and numbers. Here we go. All right, we're gonna do your letters first. Who's our favorite guy? His name is Robert. Robert begins with R, the letter R for Robert. Next up is that O, the ah sound that we hear in Robert. Next one is that B sound that we hear in Robert's. Perfect. Next up is the E and the R. We put them together, E and R, to make that sound that we hear in Rob. T, the letter T. R-O-B-E-R-T. R-O-B-E-R-T, that spells our favorite guy, Robert. Perfection. All right, let's get started on tracing out our letters. So get your red paint bag so we can trace out our letters. The first letter is the letter R that we hear in Robert, the letter R. We do one straight line down, one circle at the top, and a diagonal line coming down to make the letter R for Robert. Next up is the O, the sound that we hear in Robert, the letter O. We do circles around and around and around and around for the letter O on that paint circle bag. Perfect. Next up, the letter B. B. One straight line down, one circle, and another circle. Meet at that line for the letter B. B. Next up is the letter E, the E and the R. They are two for, they come together to make that sound that we hear in Rob. First up is that letter E. One straight line down, three little lines across to make that E. And then the R is just like at the beginning, one straight line down, one circle, and then one line down. Perfection. And the last one is the letter T. T. One straight line across, one line down for Robert T. R-O-B-E-R-T. R-O-B-E-R-T. That spells our favorite guy, Robert. Excellent job, buddy. Make sure that you practice tracing all of those on your paint bag, and make sure you take some time to do that on your iPad as well, either by pausing this video or at the end of the lesson. We're gonna keep rocking and rolling right into our numbers so we can get back to the good fun music stuff. We're gonna start with our first one, the number one. There is only one Robert Bursey. He has one nose, one mouth, one heart, the number one. We drag over our one counter for the number one. Excellent. Next one, the number two, for two eyes, two ears, two lungs that help you breathe. The number two. We're gonna drag over one and two for two eyes, two ears, two lungs that help you breathe. Good job. Next up is the number three. We have aliens and Robert Bursey sometimes have three of something. Drag them over one and two and three. Very good. Next up is that number four. If we take our one, two hands and our three, four feet, that gives us the number four. One, two, three, four. Drag them over one and two and three and four. Very good. Next up is the number five. The number five for a high five. Numbers one, two, three, four, five, high five. Drag them over one and a two and a three and a four. And a five, high five, very good. Let's get to drawing. So make sure you have that red paint bag again. We're gonna get started drawing each of our numbers, starting with the number one. For one Robert Bursey, one nose, one mouth, one heart, one, we do one straight line down, very good. The number two, for two eyes, two ears, two lungs that help you breathe. The number two, one rounded line at the top, one line down, one line across. The number two, one, two. Very good. Next up, the number three. For the aliens and Robert Bursey sometimes have three of something. Sometimes aliens have three eyes, three arms, three legs, lots of silly stuff. For one, two, three. When we make the number three, we do one curved line, meet in the middle, another curved line, meet in the middle. Very good, buddy. Next up is the number four. For our one, two hands and our three, four feet, we have the number one, two, three, four. When we make a number four, we do one straight line, one line across, and then one line straight down the side for the number four. And lastly, our number five for a high five. One, two, three, four, five, high five. We do one line across the top, one little line down, and then the big half a circle at the bottom for the number five. You've already practiced them on your paint bag. You're gonna practice them on the iPad either right now or at the end of the lesson. Let's count them out one more time. We're gonna move one counter for one Robert Bursey, one nose, one mouth, one heart, one. We're gonna move one, two counters for two eyes, two ears, two lungs that help you breathe, the number two. Next up, the number three for aliens and Robert Bursey sometimes have three of something. One, two, and three, very good. Next up, we take our one, two hands and our three, four feet. We drag up one, two, three and four. And the last one, if we count them out, one, two, three, four, five, we can get our high five. Excellent, excellent. Let's get these slides set up for you and mom to work on today. And we're gonna roll right into our fun song that I hope you are enjoying. I know I am. Let's keep on keeping on. Perfect. These up for you, and then we'll get into the good stuff, the fun stuff. Okay, Robert and Mom, let's get ready for taking care of business. Here we go. Thank you. Off on you. I think you're probably starting to like it. So our occupation today is a superhero, and not just any superhero, because there's superheroes all over the place. Batman and Spider-Man or a policeman or a fireman. We're talking about your own personal superhero, who is your mom. We're talking about moms who are superheroes. You're going to listen to a very quick story about a mom hero. Then we're going to talk about what your craft is for your mom today. So here we go.
Hello, welcome to Frenchie's Mommy's channel. Click on that subscribe button for more videos and more books for children.
Hero Mom by Melinda Harden, illustrated by Brian Langdo. Our moms are superheroes. My mom doesn't live over tall buildings, she builds them. My mom doesn't fly in to save the day. Well, sometimes she does. My mom doesn't command animals. She works with them to find missing people and dangerous objects. My mom can transform into a machine, but she can make airplanes fly, trucks run, and tanks roll. My mom doesn't have superhuman speed, but she gets everything where it needs to go, just in time. My mom doesn't have super healing powers. Well, maybe she does. My mom doesn't lead a band of superheroes. She leads a battalion. Even though our moms go away on long trips, we feel the super love for us in their letters, pictures, and phone calls. Our moms are American soldiers. Our moms are heroes, our superheroes. The end.
Thank you for watching Frenchie Mommy's channel. Hope you enjoyed our video. If you would like to see more, please like, share, and subscribe.
Excellent, 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 excellent. All righty, Mom and Robert, our hero today. You're making a craft that's just for moms. So in that story, we talked about a mom being a hero because she was in the army, and moms are heroes in lots of different ways. And Robert, your mom is a hero because she takes such good care of you and everybody else in your house and everybody else around her. She makes sure that you specifically have every single thing that you need and pretty much everything that you want too, because you have her wrapped around your little finger. But Mom is definitely your personal superhero. So you're gonna be making some Wonder Woman superhero accessories for Mom today. So let's take a look. You can see in your bag, you're gonna have that yellow piece of construction paper that's like the triangle right here. And then the two cuffs as well. All you've gotta do is paint or color that those three stars red, connect them onto each of the pieces, measure Mom's head to make the Wonder Woman crown, and then measure your wrists as well. So it's just something for Mom. Sure, how much we appreciate her because she is your superhero. Hope you guys had a lot of fun. I can't wait to see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.